back, folks, to another RWD screencast. Today we're going to be talking again about Phaser and building games for the web to make cross-platform two-dimensional games. We are going to be taking a look at two new concepts today. The first one is going to be controlling the game camera, the second of which is going to be creating static assets on the game. So the first is going to be giving us the ability to zoom the camera in and be able to have a game world that is larger than the viewing window. The second piece is going to be to create interfaces on the game. So if you want to have life meters or other things that are going to be prominently displayed and persist throughout the game when the camera moves, we'll be taking a look at that. So a couple of things that I want to make edits to in order to make this work. The first thing is we need to make some changes in the game.js. In the game.js previously, we had values of 480 by 360 for the actual game. This was the div that's on the page that's going to present the game. And what we actually want to do is we want to reduce the height and width of that, because we want the viewing area to actually only display a portion of the game screen at a time. So what we're going to do here is we are going to change this to 240 by 180. And what this is going to do is it's going to give us a window that's only going to show about a quarter of the screen at a time, so that when the character moves to the left or right, we want the camera to pan along with them and follow them throughout the game. So we are also going to make some changes to the load.js. We're adding in a new asset here. This is our life bar. We're going to be calling it life bar. That's what we'll be referencing it later. And we are going to be pulling it in from this life bar PNG, which I have created a new folder within our sprites for interface. And this is the life bar PNG. So we want to add this in so that later on when we start building out the interface, we can use this. This image was downloaded from Yo-Yo Games. It's was from a game maker file, which I will link to in the show notes. So cool. We've got our assets loaded. We've updated our game. Now what we want to do is we've made our viewing window 240 by 180. But we still want the game world to match the actual height and width of our tile map. So when we set the bounds for our game world here, what we're going to do is we're going to keep this as 480 and 360. So these don't necessarily need to match the values from the game.js. We just need to take that into account when the player goes off screen. We're going to need to move the camera along with them. We are going to set the X and Y coordinates of the camera right here to 300 by 200, which the reason why we're setting those values is because when we're placing the character on the screen, we want the camera to actually, the placement of the camera to be relative to where the player is starting. Now, what we're going to want to do here in order to make sure that the camera is now going to follow our player around is within our update function for our player, in addition to moving the player, where we call the move function on the sprite, we're also going to move the X and Y coordinates of the camera to be relational to the X and Y coordinates of the player. What this will do is it'll allow the camera to shift by the same number of pixels that the player is moving when they go off screen. So this should pretty much take care of what we want for a camera perspective. So let's take another look at our player here. So you can see we've adjusted the height and width of the play area so that it's only showing the portion of the screen that the player is occupying. And now when we move from spot to spot on the game, you'll see that the camera is going to follow our player as well. Now this works from a presentation perspective. Now, like I said, what we want to do is we want to add some assets onto the page which are actually going to serve as an interface to provide some feedback to the user on things like life, health, number of lives left, things like that. So we'll be doing that by going back to our program here, and within our create function, I'm going to uncomment some of this stuff over here. Let's do that right. We're going to create two new objects. One is going to be the text. I'm just calling it T here. And it's going to add some text to the page. And I'm going to give it coordinates of 0 and 165. So this will place it on the left-hand side of the screen, but towards the bottom of the screen so that it'll always be, it won't block any of the actual gameplay. We're going to use the text of life. And we're going to give it the font and fill and align properties here as the fourth parameter. Let's take this out for now. I'll get to that shortly. Then we also want to create the life bar. The life bar is going to be a sprite. It's going to be that sprite that we loaded into our load.js of the life bar. We are going to add it the same way we add all of the other sprites, but we're going to give it a position of 20. Because we want it to be next to the words life, and 165 because we want it to align at the same height as the text for life. And we're going to give it a value of life bar, which if you remember from our load.js, that's the value that we gave the asset that we loaded. And lastly, we want to scale it to about 25% height and width so that it doesn't take up too much real estate on the page. So let's save this and let's just do a quick refresh here. So that looks pretty good. We now see life here and we see the life bar below it. But watch what happens here. If I move off screen, the life bar is not going with me. So Phaser offers this fixed to camera property for our text and for our sprites. So if we set the fixed to camera equal to true, now if I go off screen, the even though I've moved away from the initial spot that that life bar and text was presented, it still stays in the same position. So if you're used to using CSS, this is like a position absolute. It's always going to place it on the same page on the same place on the page. And that's pretty much it. You can use that to then you could store some properties of the player and present them back in that interface within your game. You can use that for placing things at the top of the screen as well, and just give your game a little bit of feedback so that if the player loses some life, then you can adjust those life bars accordingly and do the needful. That is pretty much it. Just a couple of quick tips here for how to make your game a little bit more a little bit more user-friendly, and hopefully this is helpful. If you have any questions, YouTube comments, Twitter at Ignore Intuition, make sure you subscribe, make sure you share, make sure you you know, keep up on our screencasts as we make them available, and thanks everybody for watching.